Hi, and thanks for joining us on 2K Sports NBA Action. It's coming up. I'm Brian Anderson, and joining me at the table, Richard Jefferson and Grant Hill. We've also got Ali LaForce bringing us reports. And a chance now to take a look at some numbers for Patrick Beverley.
And over the last five games, his field goal percentage has increased. And you can make a case his confidence as well because of this.
Before we get started, we've got just enough time to head over to the sideline. Allie?
Thanks, Brian. Well, the arrival of Chris Paul to Phoenix turned this team into a contender. Coach Monty Williams said, quote, "He's brought such a winning mentality. Off the court, on the court, lifting the level of our team. I don't have enough time to talk about everything that he has done." Brian?
One of the all-time greats, Allie. No question about it. Well, Grant, we've got two savvy veteran teams on the court. So you don't expect a lot of mistakes or sloppy play tonight.
Yeah, definitely a lot of experience on the floor, so teams will play the right way. These guys know exactly what they're doing. If both squads can keep things tight, we could be in for a very competitive game.
So let's take a look at the Los Angeles Lakers starting lineup. LeBron is the four with Davis at the five as they go small. Dennis Schroeder is out there with Patrick Beverley. And it's Walker in at the three, the small forward. And for the Suns, the deadly pair of Paul and Booker are the backcourt. DeAndre Ayton is out there with Torrey Craig. And it's Bridges in at the three. Now, here is James. What a tremendous game he played against Denver. Walker with it. Now guarded by Ayton. Walker's shot is off. And it's Phoenix's ball. Craig passes to Paul. Craig with a screen on Schroeder. Back to Craig. Clock at six. For three, Booker. The shot comes out, and it's the Lakers the other way. They're coming off a win against the Nuggets.
Oh, man, they were in total control, really doing anything they wanted. It was that level of dominance.
It really is fun seeing an offensive function like a well-oiled machine. I'll be interested to see if they can keep doing this.
Now here's Booker. A 14-point game for him in the win against the Clippers in Los Angeles. Bridges, a screen on Beverley. Booker for three. Schroeder with a rebound. James against Paul. Down low. Here's Davis. Oh, an amazing finish with a hand right in his face.
Too big, too skilled. Davis in the face of good defense that time.
First minute and a half of basketball played here in this one. Outside Paul. Shot from 12. Rebounded by the Lakers. The Suns beat them last time when these two met in Phoenix.
And in their last game against this club, turnovers really were a problem for them.
And they have to clean that up. Play smart and value the ball.
Now here's Davis. He's coming off a 10-point game against Denver.
This is where you want AD to get his shots. That's almost automatic.
And so here's Phoenix. Nothing up yet on the scoreboard for him.
And the Phoenix Suns have been a completely different team since acquiring Chris Paul. He's the leader of this team, and he helps set the tone on both ends.
Oh, wow. Okay, we're going to start the game with four straight misses. Look, that's about as rough as it gets. It'll get going soon.
Davis with a screen on Paul. Here's Schroeder into the lane, and the basket is good. Boy, the city of Phoenix really embracing Chris Paul as soon as he arrived.
Yeah, I mean, he's in the latter stages of his career now. But you would never know it based on how hard he plays every single night. He just makes everyone on this team so much better.
Now a timeout called by Phoenix. Now let's check out the Western Conference standings and see how they look here in December. You take a look at Phoenix. At the midway point of the season, they're in fourth place in their respective conference. And, of course, the Lakers not posing much of a threat right now.
Well, I think for Phoenix, as of late, they've looked a little out of sorts, and that's really what's knocked them out of the top spot in the standings.
They've got plenty of time left to get back to being the team we thought they'd be heading into the year, but they better do it quick.
Now here's Paul. He picked up 15 in their last win against the Clippers in Los Angeles. Laid it in with a nice touch off the window.
And finally, a made shot. They look a little relieved after that one.
All right, here's a tip for the defense in this one. Avoid sending Chris Paul to the line at all costs, because he will punish you if you do.
The ball's knocked loose. The Suns have gone 1-5 to start things off. Ayton, a screen on Schroeder. And Paul gets it to go. Paul's got his second basket on the night. Well, when it comes to free throw shooting, Paul is one of the best in the league.
Well, in 2021, he was the best in the league, hitting 93% of his shots he took from the stripe. You're simply better off letting him take the shot clean.
And the Lakers have possession, following the score by Phoenix. Here's James. And he lays it up and in.
Good work on the block. I like when LeBron gets aggressive this close to the rim.
Outside Paul. Craig with a screen. Paul with it. Picked up by James. Paul against Schroeder. Shot clock at 6. Oh, nice D from Schroeder.
And you don't see that every day. Usually he'll convert when he gets that close to the rim.
Paul against James. Pass to Davis. The Lakers got to get one up. Late clock. Craig against Schroeder. Craig passes to Paul. Back to Craig. Now Booker. Beverly defending. Out of bounds. It'll be Lakers ball. Šarić checks in for Phoenix. Payne comes in for Paul. Brown, he's checked in for the Lakers. Russell Westbrook comes in for Schroeder. A minute 29 left in the first. Westbrook against Payne. Pass to Davis. That's good. And so Westbrook with the assist. Davis has got 6.
It's the confidence I love when Davis just catches it and shoots it. He doesn't second guess himself. He just lets it fly.
Payne, the pass to Ayton. Uses the glass on the layup.
Attacking in the painted area. Clearly that was their game plan coming in.
For Los Angeles, they've gotten 5 of 7 shots to fall. Beverly outside. Davis with a screen on Šarić. The putback.
Getting out to a nice lead. Great flow and great execution.
For Phoenix, they've gone 3 of 8 so far. Šarić, a screen on Beverly. Beverly against Booker. Shoots over Beverly. Booker, no good.
Oh, I can see some miscommunication on defense there very clearly. They were super fortunate it didn't torch them with that mistake.
Now here's Westbrook. Still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game from him. Payne against James. James with the block.
Oh, look at the old man still getting it done on defense. LeBron James still takes great pride in rejecting shots.
And the foul on Anthony Davis. That's his first foul of the game. Seven seconds left in the first. 1 second left. The shot's good.
With the utmost belief in his game, he's able to beat opponents in a number of ways.
And that concludes the first quarter play. The Lakers on top, up by four. And quarter number two will get underway just after this short break. For those of you just tuning in, second quarter action is where we are. And a chance for a moment to check out the scoring breakdown for the Lakers. Well, with roster sizes expanding and the addition of two-way contracts, the NBA has 100 more roster spots than around 12 years ago. RJ, how's that changed things in your mind?
Well, you just need so much more scouting and development, and you look at the different teams around this league, the ones that have continued success are the ones that are always able to find those diamonds in the rough. It's easy to get somebody good with the top five pick. Show me a team that can find somebody with the 30th or 35th pick.
So on the floor for the Lakers to kick off the second quarter, Davis and Bryant, the two big men up front. Kendrick Nunn out there with Russell Westbrook, and it's Brown in at the small forward position.
And one move ahead of the defense, a solid pick.
And then the monster dunk to complete the play. Well done.
Well, great chemistry on display. He understood where to put the screen in order to free up his teammate.
Here's Paul. The Lakers getting their last shot to go. Okogie's shot is off. Westbrook outside. For three. That one falls. Coming off Davis' feed. Westbrook's got his first bucket of the game, and he's on the board for three. Things just don't seem to be clicking for them offensively.
Yeah, they really need to find a way to get back on track.
Here's Paul, and Davis with the block. Out of bounds, it'll be Phoenix's ball. And the Suns will go for a different look here. DeAndre Ayton, he's checked in for Biombo. Craig comes in for Šarić. Mikal Bridges checked in for Okogie, and it's Booker in for Lee. The Suns trailing. We're about a minute and a half into the second quarter now. Here's Paul. Nice shot from 10 feet out. Paul's got six.
The defense looking lazy there. You can't allow Paul to get inside like this. That's just asking for trouble.
James against Craig. And there's the foul. It's on DeAndre Ayton. That's his first foul of the game. Schroeder, he's checked in for the Lakers. Outside Walker. They get the rebound. The basket counts and one. He'll go to the line, a chance at a three-point play.
Stayed with it, and his effort is rewarded with the second chance bucket.
Free throw, no good. Phoenix has gone 0 for 2 from outside in the second quarter. Ayton with a screen. Booker, the pass to Ayton. Stolen by Bryant. Pass to Walker. And here's Schroeder outside. The rebound by Bridges. The Suns have gotten only one of four shots to go in. Going for the lob, and that one goes out of bounds. Last touch by Paul.
Those are the turnovers that have coaches pulling their hair out. Why do you think I'm bald?
The Suns making a switch here. Šamić checked in. Here's Schroeder. They lead by the biggest margin of the game at 9. When you look at Mikal Bridges, He's the quintessential 3-and-D wing, Richard.
With his quick feet and 7-foot-1 wingspan, he can guard 1 through 4. And they call him the Warden for a reason. When he locks people up, he puts them in McHale jail.
Here's Shamet. He's been productive, averaging just over 7 points a game. Knocks down the triple.
A reliable 3-point sniper. I like seeing Booker connect from downtown.
Now here's Schroeder. Bryant, a screen on Booker. Here's Schroeder. Here's Bryant. That one falls, coming off Schroeder's feed. Bryant's got 4 points this quarter.
They're finding ways to get the ball into the paint. 5 consecutive buckets.
The Suns have gotten 2 of 5 shots to fall this second quarter. Pass to Booker. Here in the second quarter, just under 3.5 minutes played.
Whether it's off the dribble or on the catch, it don't matter. Booker is one of the most proficient mid-range shooters.
James with the ball over Craig. James can't get it to go. Walker against Bridges. And he'll draw the foul. He'll head to the line for 2.
And think about this. In an era of load management, McHale Bridges is a rarity. He has never missed a game in college or the NBA.
Shooting 2.
That free throw, no good. And if you talk to Bridges, Grant, he really credits his mom for his determination on and off the court.
You know, B.A., it's a terrific story. Now, she actually made the NBA before McHale did. She joined the 76ers organization in 2015, 3 years before McHale was drafted.
Payne's checked in for Devin Booker. And he sinks the second. The Lakers in the lead. Pass to James. James double-teamed. Back to Beverly. Bryant, a screen on Payne. Beverly with it. Now guarded by Ayton. And the ball out of play. The Suns will have it. And the Lakers making a change here. Davis has checked in. .152 left in the second. Outside Craig. Right wing, pass to Shamet. To the paint. Here's Craig. And he can't get that one. And Los Angeles the other way now. Next matchup, they'll be at home against the Wizards. And that's a 1-game homestand for the club. Inside. Beverly against Payne. And Beverly gets it to go.
We've seen that more than once today. An effortless basket inside.
102 left to play in the second quarter. The shot by Payne, no good.
I'll tell you what, they've been aggressive and they've been physical.
Shot from 12. James can't get it to go. The Suns have gotten 5 of 8 attempts to drop since the second began. Beverly against Payne. Ayton with a screen. Beyond the arc. James with a steal. 30 seconds left in the second period. And it goes. As the official calls the foul, count it, and he'll shoot one more at the line. And a new group getting ready for the Suns. Biyombo, he's checked in for Ayton. Šarić comes in for Craig. Okogie's checked in for Bridges, and it's Lee in for Shamet. Nunn's checked in for Los Angeles. Russell Westbrook comes in for Beverly. That free throw, good from James.
LeBron James going to the free throw line. Let's just say it's not his most accurate of positions, but hey, even players like him got to have things that need to work on.
Now here's Payne. an important role in this offense, averaging around 12 and a half per game. Just five to shoot. 20 feet out, and Davis with the block. And so it's Los Angeles earning this break in the action, up 10. Defense is setting the tone. We'll be back in a moment.
Hello, basketball fans. First up on the agenda, let's take a look at the action going on around the NBA. Okay, now time for 2K Trivia, one-on-one. Tonight, after the game, who wins?
Come on, EJ. You think I'm going to let Little Man even get a shot off?
I'm being serious. There's no way Shaq could keep up with me. I'd run circles, like literal circles around this guy.
All right. I got something to look forward to postgame. Taking some time now to look at our matchup. Well, everything is going right for the Los Angeles Lakers.
I'll guarantee you something right now. They wouldn't be leading without their bench. That second unit came out on fire.
I don't know if that's a guarantee or if you're just spitting facts.
That's a guarantee, Ernie.
That's it for us. Thanks for tuning in. Now let's send you over to Brian Anderson with the third period.
And if you just join it in, one half is in the books. One half to go. You got to like what Anthony Davis has done in this game.
And in the first half, he dominated in the post. He got the looks he wanted and was able to execute.
The question now is, will the defense keep letting him punish them inside? Or did coach have some new ideas for them?
Well, for those just tuning in, thanks for being with us. Second half of this game still to play. The deadly pair of Paul and Booker are the backcourt. Mikal Bridges is out there with Torrey Craig. And it's Ayton in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. And that's the group for Monty Williams as we begin the second half.
They really have a commanding lead, not just in points, but in rebounds as well.
Walker for three. It's hauled in by the Suns. Ayton's got five rebounds in the game. Craig against Beverly. Craig passes to Ayton. And Davis with the block.
And this is how AD led the league in block shots. It's not just his wingspan, but it's his awareness, his basketball IQ when it comes to reading the game.
And what a phenomenal replay of that impressive rejection.
Oh, amazing indeed. And getting stops like that only encourages him to keep attacking on the offensive end.
On defense, the Lakers. 10-point lead. This is their biggest of the game. All right, Richard, I was looking over your accomplishments, doing a little extra prep on you. An NBA title with the Cavs, a state title in high school, and almost won it all in college at Arizona. Is that the one what-if in your career?
Oh, no. Thank you for bringing those up. But, yeah, I have tons of what-ifs. I have, you know, obviously the college championship. I also got Athens in the 04. And, look, just for giggles, I also like to talk about the two times I lost in the NBA Finals going against Shaq and Kobe, then Tim Duncan, David Robinson, and Manu Ginobili. But the funny thing is, it's not like they didn't have Hall of Fame head coaches. It was only Phil Jackson and Greg Popovich. So, you know, I've run into a few buzzsaws in my day.
The Suns have gotten only one of four shots to fall in the second half. Pass to Craig. Back to Paul. Down to five on the shot clock. They double team Paul. For three, Booker. They get it back. It's going to be on LeBron James. That's his first foul. Bryant, he's checked in for James. Beverly against Booker. And that one goes in as he's fouled. It'll be 3 points if he converts the free throw.
What you have to admire about Devin Booker is how much he scores the rock, as well as all the different ways he's able to finish.
And Booker is a guy you can lean on to help shoulder the offensive load, Richard.
Yeah, he's comfortable taking a lot of shots for his team. He's a volume shooter for a reason, because he understands how to score at an efficient clip, too.
Now here's Schroeder. Looking at his numbers, currently he's averaging around 9 points a game. Paul with some nice D.
And they have been cold coming out of the break, only getting one of their first four shots to drop this half. Got to pick it up.
Pass to Walker. Back to Schroeder. Outside Walker from behind the arc. The Lakers with another miss.
Out of halftime, not the way you want to execute. Just one of five from the field.
Paul passes to Aiden. And here's Booker. Shoots over Beverly. And there's Booker. That one's good. On the assist by Aiden. Booker's got 10 points.
The execution has been better lately. But do they have enough energy to pull it off?
The thing they have to watch for is mental fatigue. They have to stay focused and finish the job.
Now here's Beverly. Davis with a screen on Booker. Beverly, the pass to Davis. And finished off by Davis.
A premier player in this league, Davis with another huge night, showing why he is an NBA champion.
Paul against Schroeder. Goes up on the baseline. Paul can't get it to go. For Los Angeles, they've got just 2 of 6 in the second half. Second half here, and we're just over 3.5 minutes into it. Walker passes to Bryant. Out to Schroeder. Just 5 on the clock. They set the pick. 4-3. The rebound by Bridges. The Suns have gotten just 3 of 8 shots to go in the third quarter. Pass to Paul. Over Schroeder. Off the left rim and out.
Not his best efficiency this quarter. Look, sometimes that's how it goes.
Beverly finds Schroeder. Beverly, a screen on Paul. Out to Beverly. Hey, puts up a 3. And it's Phoenix with the rebound. They'll be playing host to New Orleans for their next one. That'll be their second of a 5-game stretch at home. Back to Booker. The 3. Davis with a rebound. Davis has got 7 rebounds in the game. Paul against Beverly. Schroeder with it. Pass to Davis. Shoots over Ayton. Davis misses.
And he felt like he needed a little bit more space with the fade to get off a shot, but that might have been what threw him off and made him miss.
Ayton, a screen on Schroeder. Booker with it. He's picked up by Schroeder. Phoenix no good that time either.
Surprising he didn't bury that, but hey, it happens sometimes.
Beverly into the lane. And stolen by Paul. Booker against Beverly. Outside Paul. Up top Aiden. To the inside. Booker. Give him that one. Now shooting 5 for 11 from the floor.
And we've kind of come to expect this performance from Booker every night. His scoring is just that consistent.
Los Angeles has got nothing to fall here in the third. 0 for 4. Beverly, the pass to Bryant. Right side Davis. Fade away. And Craig pulls it down. Craig's got 5 rebounds tonight. Pass to Booker. And the call is going to be yes on an illegal screen.
You're not going to fool the officials too often on an illegal screen.
That's a very avoidable turnover. You got to focus on the details.
He got it off in time. Oh, and the release was before the buzzer, but it's off target. And we've watched 3 so far in this one. Lakers ahead, leading by 4. And we're coming right back after this break to get the fourth quarter started. three tense quarters behind us. One more to go. Thanks for being with us as we get ready for the fourth. The Lakers in the lead. And so in the game for Los Angeles, LeBron is the four with Davis at the five as they go small. Russell Westbrook out there with Kendrick Nunn, and it's Brown in at the three. And that one's good. James.
Love to see that kind of activity. He just makes things happen.
Payne, the pass to Šarić. Back to Payne. Pass to Okogie. Six on the shot clock. Šarić, a screen. Okogie's shot is off. And for the Lakers, they're shooting 44%, a pretty decent clip. James passes to Nunn. Now here's Westbrook, defended by Payne. Davis with a screen on Payne. And so he draws the foul, headed to the line to shoot a pair.
When I think of Westbrook, I think of one of the most intense players ever to play the game. A true competitor doing whatever it takes to will his team to a win.
And breaking down some numbers here, the hustle stats for the Lakers.
Two shots.
And that one falls for Westbrook. So Westbrook nails both of them. Fourth quarter of basketball. We're about a minute into it. Westbrook against Payne. Oh, and there's the whistle on the shot. So two free throws for him coming up. It's on LeBron James.
Yeah, and you never want to let shots at the rim go uncontested.
Campaign is the perfect example of how beneficial the G League can be, Richard.
Yeah, it gave him a chance to play real minutes, and it kept him sharpening his skills. Then he got to come back into the league better than ever, a true success story.
First free throw is good. Mikal Bridges checked in for the Suns. Both shots good from the stripe. Fourth quarter still young, just over a minute played. James against Šarić. James inside. No one on him. Makes an easy one. And the Lakers lead by eight.
Such a skilled and intelligent scorer. James just knows when he should look to capitalize.
To the wing, right side. Pass to Lee. Now here's Šarić. Five to shoot. Here's Bridges. Biombo with it. Checked by Davis. Biombo can't hit.
They timed up the layup perfectly. The D saw it develop and got there to bother the shot.
And the foul called on Bismack Biombo. That'll be a second foul of the game.
Tough break for the defense. I mean, he took the hit, but he didn't get the call.
Ayton, he's checked in for Phoenix. Booker comes in for Lee. And the Lakers also making a switch. Reeves is checked in for Brown. Pass to James. Oh, LeBron hammers it home.
One of the most ferocious dunkers we've ever seen. James still enjoys putting on a show.
And how about our AT&T 5G slam cam? Couldn't have captured that play any better. Phoenix is shooting at 32% from the floor. Not good. Payne, pass to Ayton. That's tipped and stolen by Nunn. From 8 feet, gets it. He's 6-for-10 and looking confident out there.
This run has been fueled by their Matador defense.
Over 2.5 minutes in the books here in the fourth. Bridges, a screen on Westbrook. And here's Payne outside. And again, it's the Suns missing. Now Los Angeles with it. They've outscored them 10-2 during this run. James with the ball, picked up by Šarić. Sinks it again. That's his 7th made field goal in 11 tries.
Just so successful getting the ball inside and finding those great looks.
Booker against Nunn. Ayton, a screen on Nunn. And he lobs it up to the rim! Stolen by Davis. James against Šarić. And he was fouled while in the act of shooting, so he'll take 2 free throws.
Now, nobody spends more time in the paint than LeBron James. He knows he's going to get the contact, and he still goes in there.
Shooting 2.
That free throw, good from James. Some changes for Phoenix. Craig's checked in for Šarić, and it's Paul in for Payne. Walker, he's checked in for the Lakers. Beverly comes in for Nunn. And that's good as he hits both shots. A look at the clock, a little under 3.5 minutes gone by in the fourth. Phoenix calls timeout.
Protecting the rim has to be their top objective right now.
I'm sure coach is going to give them an earful about that. He can't be happy with that soft interior D.
Outside Booker. Craig with a screen on Beverly. Here's Booker. That one off the back iron and out.
It's obvious they're becoming frustrated. Nothing seems to be going their way.
In a major drought, need to find some sort of momentum.
And here's Craig. Pass to Booker. Can they get it? And he was fouled in the act of shooting. Opportunity for a 3-point play here.
How does he do that? Booker absorbs the foul but stays cool, knocks down the shot.
Already a terrific career for Booker. 3-time All-Star, and then last year he was named to the All-NBA first team. Just a big honor.
Shooting 1.
That free throw good from Booker. And with Booker, it's not just the scoring. Grant, he does a little bit of everything.
Hey, B.A., I mean, you go back and look at last season. He had career highs in rebounds, steals, blocks. I mean, he's learned how to affect the game even when his shot isn't falling, which is rare.
Oh, nothing soft about that.
Was not going to be denied. Just took the dunk that was right in front of him.
And that's his MOB physical, get in position for the putback and throw it down. The defense got to know that's what he's looking to do.
And here are the Suns now, following the score by the Lakers. Booker for three, counted from distance. Booker's got 6 points in the quarter.
This is Booker at his most dangerous. No hesitation right there.
And the Lakers shooting efficiently, 50% so far. It's James on the wing. And out of bounds, the Suns will take it. There's a minute 26 left in the fourth quarter of this one. Booker against James. That one won't go. That's his eighth miss out of 15 shots. Davis a screen. James passes to Davis. Ooh, excellent D there from Ayton. Phoenix has gone 1-for-3 in the fourth quarter from range.
Barring a miracle comeback, this one is wrapped up. They were able to control the tempo and flow of the game, and it will end in a victory for the Lakers.
Offensively, they made the most of their trips.
They found multiple ways to score consistently, and a little luck doesn't hurt them either. They also got some nice bounces off the rim tonight, too.
This will mark their 13th win of the year. Not a bad number. And one player just stole the show tonight, doing everything for his team. A monster night for Anthony Davis.
He limited the opposing offense's impact as well with some superb defense, finding lots of chances to knock away shots.
There's 39 seconds left to play in the fourth. Double team on James. Walker, a good look. The shot's good on the assist by James. And the Lakers lead by 8.
They have a relentless mentality, even with the game in total control.
No let up with these guys. They're going for the throat now.
Here's Paul. The Lakers getting their last shot to go.
How about the little guy throwing himself on the glass?
Pass to Davis. Up and in on the layup.
This is what winning is all about. Playing your best when it matters most.
And let me tell you, as a team, you love to hit your stride right at the crucial moments. They put this game away in style.
Here's Westbrook. And so it's the Lakers easily grabbing this one. They have to feel good about this performance. It's one they can be proud of.
Very true. I mean, when you're out on the road, the wins can feel a little sweeter. This one has to feel extra special.
And now let's check in with Allie LaForce with the player of the game. Allie.
Anthony, it was a great team victory tonight. What satisfied you most about this win?
We just played hard. You know, we just played for each other. The ball was moving, wasn't sticking. And, you know, guys made the right plays. You know, and that's what we've been doing all night, all season. And you know, I'm just glad we came out with the win.
Selfless basketball is a beautiful thing, guys.
All right, Allie, thank you. And that about wraps it up. This is Brian Anderson, along with our 2K Sports crew, thanking you for tuning in. Now it's time to present our New Balance Player of the Game, Anthony Davis.